We want to calculate 5 to the power of x using a loop. So we know that raising a number to a power is the same as repeated multiplication. So what our loop is going to do is start with the number 1 and multiply it by 5 x times. So in this solution, we're using a for loop to multiply 1 by 5 x times. We can see that this is going to repeat as many times as is x. If x were to be 0, this would execute, it would not iterate at all, and our result would be 1, which is what we want. So we're making an assumption here that we're not going to have any negative values of x, just to keep things simple. And we have a return value of int, which returns our result. Recursion in this case works by breaking the problem down into smaller and smaller problems. So for example, let's say the program wants to calculate 5 to the power of 4. We know 5 to the power of 4 is equal to this expression. So what the program is going to do now is figure out what 5 to the power of 3 is. So 5 to the power of 3 is 5 times 5 squared. So now we want to find out what 5 squared is. Now the problem is reduced to finding the value of 5 to the power of 1. If we can just remember that 5 to the power of 0 is equal to 1, then we can calculate this, which will calculate this. It'll calculate this quantity. We can evaluate this to evaluate this. Finally, leading back to our solution. So if we want to calculate 5 to the power of x, what we're going to do is calculate 5 times the previous power, so x minus 1. And eventually, we're going to try to figure out what 5 to the power of 0 is, and that's where this case comes in. So if x is not greater than 0, it's going to be equal to 0, and we'll return a 1. Now that we have the general strategy of how the recursion solution is going to work, let's trace through an actual example. So let's say we call this method with an argument of 3. So we're trying to calculate 5 to the power of 3. We're going to invoke that method with an argument of 3. And when we do, because x is over 0, we're going to execute this line of code. This says return 5 times power 2. So now we're trying to calculate 5 to the power of 2. So it's going to call itself, and when it does, it's going to return 5 times power 1. So that call to power 1 is going to try to calculate 5 to the power of 1, which is 5 times 5 to the power of 0. And so when we try to calculate 5 to the power of 0, we're going to execute this line of code, which is going to return a 1. So this method invocation returns 1. This returns 5 times 1, which is 5. So this method invocation is returning 5, which is what we want. 5 times 5 gets returned from the method invocation of power 2. And then we're returning 5 times 25, which is 125, which is 5 to the power of 3. In this example, we want to add the numbers from n down to 1. We could have added the numbers from 1 to n, it doesn't really matter. But so we're starting at n, and we are subtracting 1 from I. As long as I is greater than 0, we're adding that onto the result. Once we finish iterating through our for loop, we are returning our result. Let's say we want to add the numbers from 4 down to 1. What we're going to do is break this into two problems. So we're going to calculate this expression. And now what we have to do is figure out the sum of the numbers from 3 down to 1. That, of course, is equal to 2 plus 1 is just 2 plus 1. And 1, of course, is equal to 1. So in our solution here, what we're going to do is, if we want to add up the numbers up to n, we take n and we add it up to the numbers up until the previous number. And we do that as long as n is over 1. N's actually equal to 1, we're just going to return 1 because the sum of the numbers up to 1 is 1. Let's trace through this solution to understand how it works. Suppose we want to calculate the sum of the numbers up to 4. To do that, we're going to return 4 plus the sum of the numbers up to 3. That causes another invocation of our method, and when we try to calculate the numbers up to 3, what we get is 3 plus the numbers up to 2. Calculating the numbers up to 2 gives us 2 plus the numbers up to 1, and the numbers up to 1 returns a value of 1. So when this method call returns 1, this evaluates to 3. Our method call of counting the sum up to 2 returns a 3 as we want, because 1 plus 2 is 3. And so this method call of adding up the numbers up to 3 returns 3 plus 3, which is 6. And this call returns 4 plus 6, which is 10.